In the first 1,000 days of life from conception to second birth, the developing brain is most sensitive to poor nutrition. That's because nutrients play crucial roles in regulating brain development during the 1,000-day window. Adequate energy uptake, protein, fat, carbohydrate, iron, copper, zinc, iodine, thiamine, selenium, and various vitamins including vitamin A, B9 and B12, C and D, are main nutritional factors with significant effects on brain development. For the time being, we focus on three amazing effects of zinc on developing brain during the fetal period. Zinc is an important trace metal in the body, as around 10% of human proteins are zinc-dependent. Besides, it plays essential roles in the structure and function of child's brain. Severe zinc deficiency in embryo can cause overt brain malformation. Zinc deficiency after pregnancy and during infancy is associated with decreased head growth and cognitive impairment as well. The number one effect of zinc ion on brain is regulation of neuronal growth and differentiation. Neurons are fundamental units of human nervous system. It is estimated that human brain contains 86 billion neurons on average. Each neuronal cell has three specialized parts: a cell body or perikaryon, axon, and dendrites. There is a group of proteins called zinc finger, being one of the most abundant groups of proteins in human cells. As the name reveals, zinc is present in the structure of these proteins. Zinc finger proteins perform a broad range of functions by interacting with DNA, RNA, lipids, and many other proteins. These proteins are pivotal for proliferation, migration, and differentiation of neural stem cells to neurons. Second effect of zinc ion on developing brain is white matter growth. When looking at the brain, two main colors are seen: white color and gray color. The gray color area, like brain cortex, is home to neuronal cell bodies and dendrites. On the other hand, the white color areas are largely composed of axons and oligodendrocytes. Majority of axons has an insulating layer, being so-called myelin sheath. In human brain, these sheaths are produced by specific cells called oligodendrocytes. Myelin is a critical player in proper brain function, allowing electrical impulses to transmit fast and efficiently along the neurons. Like neurons, an oligodendrocyte-specific zinc finger protein is responsible for oligodendrocyte proliferation, differentiation, and function. As a reminder, zinc finger proteins require zinc ion for normal functioning. In summary, zinc seems to be an essential element in brain growth through regulating both neuronal and oligodendrocyte maturation. Another effect of zinc on brain is modulating cerebellar development. Zinc finger proteins of cerebellum are essential in cerebellar development. Additionally, experimental studies have shown that the number and differentiation of many cerebellar cells, including basket cells, Purkinje cells, stellate cells, and granule neurons, are affected by zinc ion. To sum up, suboptimal zinc nutrition during pregnancy can have long-term effects on the offspring's brain and mental health. Now the question is, how can we prevent zinc deficiency? The recommended dietary allowance for zinc is 2 to 3 mg per day in the first year of baby's life, 8 to 9 mg per day in adolescent females, and 11 to 12 mg per day in pregnant women and adolescent males. Besides, zinc deficiency is more prevalent in low-income countries like Senegal, Bangladesh, Kenya, and Nepal. Shortage of zinc in infants with prolonged exclusive breastfeeding is common. In order to avoid zinc deficiency, it's highly recommended to introduce complementary foods rich in zinc at 6 months of age. Meat, poultry, shellfish, and pumpkin seeds are excellent sources of zinc. Zinc supplementation for preventing zinc deficiency seems to be beneficial just in low-income countries. In general, adequate dietary intake of zinc is the best way of prevention. Thanks for your watching. Please let me know the pediatric issues you are willing to learn. Write them in the comments for me. Farewell.